With that,
you look great, honey.
We were joined by the next First Lady, Melania Trump. She'll be only the second foreign-born First Lady. She's from Slovenia. John Quincy Adams' wife, Louisa, was the first.
You know, I asked your husband if he was at all intimidated and scared about what lies ahead. The enormity. You're about to be First Lady. Are you a little nervous about it? A little tense, a little...
Well, there is a lot of responsibilities, and it's a lot of work needs to be done. And it's your staff on your shoulders, and we will take care of it day by day. I will stay true to myself. I'm very strong and tough and confident, and I will listen myself, and I will do what is right and what feels to my heart.
What kind of a First Lady do you think she's going to be?
She will be terrific. She is very strong and very confident, but she's very warm, and I think she'll have a platform where she'll really be able to do a lot of good, and that's what she wants to do.
You know, First Ladies usually have a cause, and you've already said you're interested in speaking out against bullying on social media.
I think it's very important because a lot of children and teenagers are getting hurt. And we need to teach them how to talk to each other, how to treat each other, and to be able to connect with each other on the right way.
It's an ironic choice, since her own husband sent out a stream of pretty nasty tweets during the campaign.
What about your husband's tweeting?
Well, sometimes it got him in trouble, but it helped a lot as well. He had unbelievable following.
So you never say to him, come on.
I did.
She does.
Lighten up.
Yes, of course, I did many times from the beginning of the campaign. But
does he listen to you?
Sometimes he listens, sometimes he doesn't.
Well, I'm not a big tweeter. I mean, I don't do too many, but they hit home and they have to get a point across.
If he does something that you think crossed a line, will you tell him?
Yes, I tell him all the time.
Yeah, all the time?
All the time.
And does he listen? Does he?
I think he hears me. But he will do what he wants to do on the end. He's an adult. He knows the consequences. And I give him my opinion, and he could do whatever he likes with it.
Did you ask Melania sort of for permission in a way to run for president? Did you get her approval?
Well, I actually sat down with Melania and my whole family, and we talked about it. Don, Ivanka, Eric, Tiffany. Barron to a lesser extent, but Barron too, because in a way he's affected every bit as much.
Sure.
Maybe more. Mm-hmm.
Maybe more.
And so we all had a dinner, and I said, I would like to do this. I think I can do a great job. And I wanted to get, number one, a consensus, and number two, ideally, their permission. And they all agreed.
Your son, Barron, what is he, 10?
10.
10. He was on camera the whole time you were giving your acceptance speech. Does he get it? Does he know?
He knows.
He knows
what's going on, and he's very proud of his dad.
Now, you met with Michelle Obama yesterday. Was there any awkwardness given
what
everybody was saying about everybody in the campaign?
No, I didn't feel it.
Not at all?
No.
Wow. Tell us about the meeting.
Yes, she was a gracious host. We had a great time, and we talked about raising children in the White House. She was very warm and very nice.
You know, she raised the two kids in the White House, but she had her mother living there. That's an enormous help. Your parents are here, right?
They are here.
Will they go to Washington with you?
They might. We will see. We will discuss that.
Are you prepared, both of you, for the lack of privacy and the intense scrutiny? And you know, First Ladies are really criticized if one little hair's out of place. Are you both prepared for this?
We are used to it, yes.
I will say it is on a different scale, though, because I've had a lot, but I've never had anything like this.
You won't be able to walk down the street?
I didn't do that for 2 years already, so, you know, it will just continue. It's another level, but it will continue.